All right, guys, we're just getting done from a trip in a whole new area that we've never fished before. Had a lot of fun today. You're really going to enjoy this episode, and we're going to just teach you how we take our style and techniques that we've been doing everywhere and how you can use a wintertime marsh pattern no matter where you're fishing at. As today, we've traveled all the way to Mississippi, got the boat on the trailer, and fishing area for the first time and had some pretty good success. Enjoy this episode of Dockside TV. Catching a few, but we ran out of daylight, so we came back out here today with Captain Steve. We're just trying to put the pieces of the puzzle together. One of my favorite redfish baits in the world is the Purple Haze Vortex, so we're gonna roll with that. Let's see what we can do here. Gotta let this one go. And it's some really cold Mississippi water. That fish tattooed that lure just now. Threw it up on this bank here, in this little, kind of a little pocket. It was falling to the bottom, and hi-yow, he crushed it. There might be a few in there. That's a good one. That's a keeper. We'll keep that one for the grill. Let me put them up in my bucket. And then I'm gonna show you just kind of the technique that we're doing here. Again, I haven't picked up the trolling motor one time, maybe once since we've been filming. Always make sure your vortex is nice and straight. But I'm kind of throwing up towards the bank. And in a lot of the banks, it's only about a foot or two, but I tell you, some of these banks, that drop off is quick. And when you feel it come off that drop off, or you see it, you want to watch your line the whole time, see it come off that drop, you need it to really give it some patience to let it settle back to the bottom, and you're just going to be working it down these slopes. And these slopes have different depths, you know. Some of them the drop off's real tight to the bank, some of them's way off. That's why, you know, if you're in a bayou that's got a lot of 10 to 12 foot of water, I'd recommend that 3/8. Now if you were in a little area that was most of it was 3 and 4 foot of water, you could use a quarter ounce. But we've been trying to stay in pretty deep water here, and using that 3/8 to help us figure out where the deeper spots are. And that's, a lot of the bites are coming kind of like on that drop that would be like going from 2 foot to 4 foot. And you know, you can see this point right here, and you got a big horseshoe bend. You know, I haven't been doing too much in the straightaways, but when you get into something abnormal like this, the big turns and the bends, that's where I'm slowing the trolling motor down, fan casting, and really spending some time trying to target them. We're not finding any big schools today, but we are. It has been pretty consistent fishing, not bad at all, and we're catching some fish. Look what we got here, Mr. Specky Goo Goo.
Oh, what in the world?
Mr. Speckle Trout. Cold as ice when I grab him. But what we're doing right now is we got an east wind. and let this guy go. It's a beautiful trout, but here in Mississippi, they need to be 15 inches. We ain't really keeping nothing today anyway, but got an east wind, incoming tide, and when you fish in a new area, you just want to put that wind and tide to your back. That way the boat flows nice and at a good clip down these bayous, and that way you can really cover some water, cover some ground. That's always important in any style of fishing, especially when you're fishing an area you've never been to before. You know, redfish, they school up real tight. That's really what we're targeting today. And we're just trying to cover a lot of ground. We learned some stuff yesterday, and we're just trying to capitalize on it today and learn some more areas back here in the Mississippi marsh. There he is back there. Come on, baby.
Another trout-asses?
There we go. That's a Mississippi keeper right there. Beautiful fish. Hitting that purple haze. Vortex shad. You know, what's crazy about this area we're fishing in Mississippi is you'll be going in, like right now, to Bayou Strait, it's only 3 foot deep. You get to a turn, and it's got 12 or 15 foot of water. So if you're trying to learn the area, I'd recommend like a 3/8 ounce. That way it's gonna help you get that bait down to the bottom fast. And you'll be able to tell if you're in 3 foot or 10 foot. And what you're looking for in the dead of the winter is gonna be them deeper turns. Just mosey on down this bayou here. Really don't even know where we're at. Got one little ditch that came out and voila, what do you know? Mr. Redfish. One of my favorite things to do in my life, you know, when we go to Florida and other places that we've never been before, you know, we might get a tip or two from the local tackle shop, and I got some friends that fish out here, but for the most part, we're just coming out here blind, using a lot of our tactics and techniques that we use in Louisiana and putting them to the test here. And, you know, a fish is a fish anywhere. They're very similar in a lot of estuaries, and you can take those presentations just about anywhere. It's working for us today. See if we get a few more.
Trout.
A red to a trout. That'll work. Again, you pretty much need a state record to have a keeper over here. You know, now, back in the day, 15 inches was nothing. Nowadays, 15-inch trout, that's nothing to sneeze at. That fish was probably about 14. I feel bad for the Mississippi anglers, though. You know, they get days out here. Some of my friends that fish it, they say they catch 20, 30, 40 trout, but can't keep with one or two of them. And I don't know, I think 15 is just a little big for this estuary. You know, when a big trout around here, you know, is like a 3 or 4 pounder, that's a big one. You know, like you go to Texas or Florida, they catching those 8, 9 pounders pretty regularly. So if you want to put the minimum of 15 inches there, it kind of makes sense. But over here, you know, when a 3 or 4 pounder is a quality, you know, a big fish, I don't know, I just think 15 is a little tough for them. And I hear my friends that fish out here complain about that all the time, is they're catching plenty of trout, they just, they can't keep them. What I'm seeing here, it's kind of odd. You know, it's not terribly cold today. When we're red fishing for reds like this in the winter, I'd rather it be really cold and super low water. The water's not that low, so I'm having a tough time really dialing these reds in. I'm catching some tight to the bank. I'm catching some relatively shallow, 3-5 foot. And then I'm catching some in these turns that are like 10 to 12 foot. So it makes it hard. Usually when you get real low water, real cold conditions, where you hit one, you're going to hit a bunch in a row. But this situation we got here, we're just catching, you know, one here, one there, putting a box together, but making it, it's pretty fun. Pretty fun. All right, there he is. There he is. Old purple haze getting it done. But I want you to look at this layout right here. Got a 90 degree point. Got another turn in the S Bayou right here. And it's funny, we'll be going down the bayou. Like I said, I don't know this area from Adam. I can feel with my 3/8 ounce jig head that it's 4 to 5 foot. And then when I threw on that point right there, I was like, golly, there's a lot of water. I go look at my depth finder. As you know, I could see my line, how long it's taking me for it to get to the bottom. I go on my depth finder and it said 16 foot, which blew my mind. Now, I didn't get a bite on that point, but I knew to really hone in on this zone and make a lot of casts, because this is a deep S turn or point here. And sure enough, there he was. And maybe there's a few. Let me get back out there and see. But again, 3/8 ounce on that purple haze. Great lure for the winter. Great lure for redfish. Great lure for a brand new area that we've never fished before. Another beautiful red, baby. A lot of fun today. Just to show you where I caught that one. The camera, see that cut right there? He was just kind of out in front of that, but not dead in the cut, out in front. And right when it came off that drop off, that's where that fish was. Go ahead and let that one go. Throw right back in there. But I hope you enjoyed this episode of Dockside TV. You know, we started off closer to the Gulf, out towards the front, and it was pure redfish coming in. You know, the tide was coming in. We dropped the trolling motor, and we've just wiggled back so far. I don't even know where I am. I'm going to have to look at the map. Just wiggling, caught reds and red after red, a few trout. We've even, as the further we came back here, we've even bumped into a few bass. Never could find anything totally ganged up, but I was been very pleased with what I've seen today with just how far we've gone and got bites the whole way. And that just tells me when we get that real low water and a real big cold front, I think we're going to come in here and really tattoo them and have some fun. But if you want to get your hands on this this month's, make sure to subscribe to this month's monthly bait box. Get your hands on the Purple Haze Vortex Shad. We'll be giving that away in this month's box. So subscribe to that. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Check them all out as we fish from Louisiana all the way to Florida. Today we spent the day in Mississippi having a good time with Captain Steve Wicks in the marshes of Mississippi, guys. Until next time, good fishing.